All right. Happy Monday, everybody. Big waves to you. Good to see you. Yes, yes, yes. I say this every week. I love our words that we got picked out for this week. So I'm excited about that. And I've been watching so many of you on social media. I just want to tell you just how proud I am of I see so many of you doing, like Andrea Grady, just in the gym, Billy getting ready for a marathon, Lance McAllister, like crushing it out there in the world, got all kinds of opportunities that he's in. And I think he's traveling today. And we just, Arlene's getting some snow up in Utah. So we're all happy about the snow, but, I just want to give you all a big shout out, man. Y'all have done so, so much and got so many good things going on in 2022. So our word for today is participate. And I really want you to think about this word today. I really, not that you don't every word every day, but I want you to think about what it is. And I'm going to ask you this a few times, but what it is right now in your life. I say this all the time, but I believe you got to keep it at the front of your mind. What is it that you really have a desire to thrive at right now? Like, what is that thing for you? You know, and it changes in life, right? Would you agree with that? Sometimes it's your business. Sometimes it's your profession. Sometimes it's your health. Sometimes it's some kind of athletic competition you're involved with. Sometimes it's you're trying to thrive and be a better parent. Like, I don't know what it is for you right now, but you do because you think about it a lot. And I want you to think about the word participate as we talk about it this morning. Because if you look at the definition, participate is take part in an action or endeavor. Take part. But take part is a big word, right? It's a big word. You know, William Arthur Ward said this. I want you to listen to this. He said, do more than belong, participate. Do more than care, help. Do more than believe, practice. Do more than be fair, be kind. Do more than forgive, actually forget. Do more than dream, work. And as I was thinking, the reason I wrote that down this morning was because I know in my life, too many times there's things I want to do, but I'm in quicksand. I'm like in this big, if you can vision this big thing of quicksand, and I'm in it and I can't move. I'm stuck. I'm not involved. I'm not participating. I wear a bracelet on my hand every day that says engage. I'm not engaging. And I don't, you know, why is that? So my question to you this morning is, are you participating right now in the thing that you're trying and wanting to thrive at? You know you need to thrive at. Let's take business, for example. Let's take that you know you need another income stream, but for some reason you won't participate in the actual activities that give you that. Why is that? And that's the question for today. So the question is, first of all, you got to admit to yourself, are you participating? For some of you, the answer is absolutely yes. And then for some of you, the answer is probably, you know what? I'm not participating like I can. That's okay. I want to share with you some reasons why. Here's some reasons why we avoid participation as adults. Maybe we've got anxiety around it. You know, I'm in sales. It could be the anxiety from picking up the phone and actually calling somebody. It could be that I just have this major anxiety, so I don't participate in that. But that's the thing that would help me build. Maybe it's the anxiety of going to the gym because you're not in shape. You don't feel athletic. You're like me. You got love handles. You know, whatever it is, you're afraid people's going to make fun of you. You have an anxiety. Maybe it's insecurity. Maybe we're going, I'm too young to do that. Have you ever thought about that in your life? Like, I can't do that. I'm too young. Or maybe I can't go with those people because I'm too old. Or maybe I can't do this because I'm too heavy right now. Or maybe I can't do this because, you know, I'm not as smart as those. I don't have a degree. I don't, you know, when you're having all these conversations of insecurity in your head, keeps us from participating. Maybe it's not knowing how to do it. I don't know how to do it, right? So I just don't do it. Maybe it's fear of ridicule. How many of you have had family or close ones, people that you love, you care about, ridicule you for things that you're doing? And it slows you up. Like it's sometimes you hesitate from participating because of it. Maybe it's fear of being wrong. What if this is the wrong thing? What if at 46 years old, I've got to go do something else? Like, oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, this is the end of the world. No, it's not. But it keeps me from participating. And then the last is sometimes it's just stinking laziness. At the end of the day, I'm just being lazy. And all of those things that I wrote down this morning are things that stop us at different times, at different areas of things that we want to thrive at. It stops us at participating. And so I want you to really think about that this morning, because 2022 is going to be a big year for us. But we're going to have all these, we're going to have great times and we're going to have these valleys. And we got to go back to these words. We got to look at them and go, am I doing this? Self-reflect and go, if I'm not, why? And then how? How do I do it? And so that's, Andrew, I know I took a little too long, but I want to turn it to you. And I know you're going to talk about the how. How, if I'm not doing it right now, how can I? So I'll turn it to you. Thanks for being here.
Well, thank you. That was a great message, Coach. And the quote that I found that I thought was really powerful was, life doesn't just happen. It requires our participation. And if we really stop and think about it for a minute, we all know the power of participation, right? The more we show up at work, the more that we're noticed and appreciated, and our paycheck can reflect that, right? The more we engage with our families, the stronger the connection, and the closer we are with our kids and our loved ones. The more people that participate in the voting process, right? The more our whole government works, right? It works better. And the more active we are at church, the more powerful the community, the more we volunteer at our kids' activities, the more kids that will benefit. Like, the more we interact with a Zoom, right? The more that we get out of the training, right? So all of it, we all know that there's so much power in participation, but sometimes we can get distracted, or, you know, all the reasons that Coach just listed, that we step back and we don't participate. So I'm going to talk a little bit today just on how we can participate more. So first of all, be present. And that's such an easy thing to say, but think about how often we're distracted. I mean, even in the 15 minutes of this Coach's Corner, I can be thinking of 47 other things, right? Ooh, I want to take a picture and go put it up on Instagram so that more people will find this community tomorrow, right? Or what do I need to, oh, I better make sure, did I do this, that, another thing? Like, we can be have all these other thoughts in our head and we're not actually present. We're thinking about, you know, what we need to do in the future, possibly what we did in the past, and we're just distracted. So try to let go of some of those distractions and just be present. You know, flip your phone over or turn it off and truly listen in the conversation. Do your best to, as Coach says, be where your feet are. And then two, show up and keep showing up. And I just think about this community, how there's so many on here. Like, I don't know what the community would look like if we didn't have Bill and Susan, right? Like, they're here every day. Will Garson, right? Like, I know. Like, I'm like, wait a minute, where's John today? Like, it's not the same without each of these different people in our community. And I could list all of you guys. So I just picked a couple that were right there. But just that this is really a part of our community. And it's what makes it so powerful, because everybody just keeps showing up, right? It's not just coach and coach like Myra and Brent on here. It's all of us showing up every single day. Third, think out loud, right? It sounds a little crazy, but think out loud when you're in a group of people or with one other person. Let them know what's on your mind, right? If they can know what's on your mind, then you can truly participate with each other. Ask how and why questions. The more we can understand a situation, the more we can participate in it. If we're not really sure, right? I don't know about you guys. Sometimes I can be a little shy, right? And I don't want to speak up. And if I don't really understand what's going on in the situation, I cannot participate, nor will I participate. So take the time, be a little brave, and ask the questions. Share a relevant story. So if you can share how you relate to what's going on, it makes you a more cohesive community. And then lastly, volunteer, right? Put in that time, put in that effort to help the whole community. So that's what I've got for you today. So grateful to participate in this community with all y'all. And I love you guys.
Andrea, thanks so much. And one of the things I want everybody to think about is, as we end the day with the word participate, is how can you participate more? Okay. And here's where I want to challenge you. Maybe it's a regular scheduled event that's going on every week for you. Okay. Now, first of all, you all participate in the Coach's Corner. So thank you for that. Thank you, because without you, there's no need for this. And you participate, and hopefully it adds value to you. But let me ask you this. Let's say it's your profession. You're trying to grow your profession. You're trying to work. You're trying to learn more. What kind of group can you go into and participate in on a daily basis, on a weekly basis, where you can gain value, but you can become more inside of that group? Like, you can learn more, you can do more. And that's where, you know, for example, that's where you can take what Andrea shared with you and apply it in those groups. Volunteer in the groups. Hey, ask him, hey, can I do this? I'd like to help you with this. Like, speak up, ask questions, like, be that participant, and then watch yourself grow. Right? Watch yourself grow, because you're engaging and you're participating. So, you know, a lot of you are doing that. So congratulations. But great word for today. Great start for this Monday, guys. We love you. We appreciate you. Find somebody today. Make them have a better day, because we showed up in their life. So we'll see you back tomorrow. Love you guys.
Thank you, Brent.
Thank you, guys.
Love you guys.
Yes,
thanks
yes,
so
yes.
Much.
Love you. Have a great day.